Get ready to match the stars. Bill Daly, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Dr. Joyce Brothers, Richard Dawson, and Patti Deutsch as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now here's the star of Match Game 75, Gene Rayburn.
Your mic's getting smaller.
But it got fatter. Oh, no.
What is this?
Thank you.
From the 40s.
Are you getting taller or is that mic getting smaller?
No, the mic is getting smaller.
You gained 4 feet.
And fatter.
Yeah, it got fatter.
What do you call this?
A microphone.
I bet it's a special kind, isn't it?
It's a thing, Gene.
Yes. Is this tougher? This one won't break like the others, huh?
That's a
you
working mic.
You can do anything with this one and it will not break, right?
Mic.
Can you do that with it?
No.
No. Okay, I won't do that with it. Can't do that either.
Nicely
got
done.
Got my striped tie.
Okay. What do you say? We say hello to Margaret Kirkpatrick and Carlo Bears. Carlo Bears. Carol Bartos. Bartos Carol. This little lady has won a total of $7,000 even. And blow your whistle. Is that blow? You broke the microphone. Oh. No, I'm only kidding. What do you use that whistle for?
Well, my husband, the policeman, has one. I want to, you know, women's lib, I have to have my whistle, too.
Oh, isn't that nice? Okay, your opponent, Carol Bartos, hasn't scored. And you have neither one of you scored. We're in the we're going to start round two, and one of you better score. Well, you better hurry back and find out what happens here. Ready?
Bing. Yo.
Round two, second and final round. Carol, please make your selection.
B, please.
B it is. Here we go. Mrs. Colonel Sanders got so angry at the Colonel.
How angry will she
get? You're improving. They're getting better, John. She went down to the chicken store and stuffed his head into a blank. That's how angry she was.
The
answer.
I do too, but I have,
I have
a funny one to go with
it. Yes.
Say it again.
Mrs. Colonel Sanders. Sanderson. You remember her. She changed her name, is what she did. She got so angry at the Colonel that she went down to the chicken store and stuffed his head into a blank.
Oh, okay.
His head. May I have a sip of your water? Thank you.
Anytime. Hey! Oh, I'm terribly sorry.
Everybody ready? Okay, Bill. Now, Carol, Mrs. Colonel Sanders got so angry at the Colonel that she went down to the chicken store and stuffed his head into a...
chicken.
Into a chicken.
No.
Now, that's a logical answer. Wait. Wait until you see what the weirdos say. Bill, what do you say?
What'd she say?
She said stuffed his head into a chicken.
I was going to say breast, but we can't say it on the air.
Right.
So I'll say bucket. I thought bucket.
Into a bucket. Yeah. Yeah. That's a pretty good answer.
Thank you. We got enough booze today.
That's right. You got the right one there. Brett, what do you say?
This is a religious question.
Yes.
Do you know what the Pope's nose is?
Yes, I do.
Well, she stuck it into the chicken's neck.
I'm with you.
That's
there.
The clean end,
yeah,
it?
Yeah, all right.
I said what this sweet boy said. With the city closed, yeah. I said bucket. I said
in the bucket, yeah.
Thank you, Captain. All right. What do you say, Joyce?
How much do I have to pay you not to show my answer?
I'm sorry, this game does not operate that way. She went down to the chicken store and stuffed his head into a chicken, according to Carol.
Chicken.
Joyce!
Joyce Brothers!
You're getting back on the bus.
Get back there. We're taking you back to New York and straighten you out. Get back. Get out there. Don't you come back until I tell you you can come back.
Oh, mon Dieu.
The idea. She said, Yeah, I told you not to come back. Now get out of here.
It's all right. She's a doctor. She can.
Oh, all right. Richard.
Doctor, your mind works in peculiar ways. I wonder if you care to come to a party Gene and I'll throw in. I said bucket.
Bucket, naturally. Bucket seems to be the popular favorite. What do you say there?
Well, those of us that do a lot of commercials refer to the commercial vernacular.
Yes.
A bucket o' cluck.
A bucket o' cluck, yeah. Okay, so that was two for you, right? Okay.
More than enough.
Now, you've got to match two to stay in the game, three to win. Harriet said.
Oh, her again.
She said. I'm going to sue that plastic surgeon.
Uh-huh. How much is she going to sue?
I don't know, probably $200,000 at least. She said, last night at the restaurant, my blank fell into the soup.
Goodness me.
That's why she's suing the plastic surgeon.
I get it, sweetheart.
Suing the plastic surgeon.
Uh-huh.
She said, last night my blank fell into the soup. Charles, ready?
You are the sunshine of my life.
Sing the other one.
What one?
I'll be singing you in all the old familiar places.
Someone. Something.
In the way you smile.
I love that song. Sing it to me.
What makes me think of Howie Cowie?
Vern and Steve. An act you'll never
forget. All right, everybody ready over there. Margaret, have you been thinking about it? I'll give you one more chance. Harriet said, I'm going to sue that plastic surgeon. Last night at the restaurant, my blank fell into my soup.
My nose.
My nose. All right, give the little lady a nose, Bill.
Okay, let's hear it for a nose. One nose coming up, please.
One nose. Yeah.
A nose is a nose by any other name.
All right. Now, Brett.
I was moving further down into the shoulder in the arm area.
Yeah.
I said her chest fell in.
Her chest.
Isn't that a cute answer?
It is. I say you
must have been a big splash.
That's right. Bang all over. You can never trust
all
that.
All over your clothes.
Charles.
Hello, darling.
I was moving down in the same area, but with a Spanish flavor.
Not too far down,
Joe.
El Busto.
I don't think we better move down anymore.
No, I think that's as far as we're going to go. I say you could never trust that silicone. Now, Joyce, last night at the restaurant, my blank fell into my soup, and Margaret said my nose.
Can she
just
says
kiss
rare.
Goodbye and go for good.
Why, you really got another rotten one.
Yes, I do.
If it's rotten, you got to boo her real strong now, because if it's
one,
rotten...
One, two, three.
Well, that's not bad. Oh. Now, wait a minute. That's not bad.
What is it?
Breast.
She said breast.
American for El Busto.
Yeah. What do you say, Richard?
The Israeli version, El Bubalo.
All right. Now, you got to match Patti to stay in the game, Margaret. Nose.
I heard you.
Nose.
Well, this is still your advertising vernacular.
What?
Your silicone upper frontal.
It's a silicone upper frontal. Congratulations to you. All right. Well, got to say goodbye, Margaret.
That's fine. I'm very happy. I had a great time. Thank you very much, all of you.
You got $7,000, Margaret Kirkpatrick. Goodbye.
Bye-bye.
Now, we'll come back right after this message. Hurry back. Here we are with Carol Bartos. What is that?
That's my son.
Oh, isn't that charming? That's a little locket ring. I don't know if you can ever get this close there. Open it up again there. And there's a picture of Carol's son in there.
That's very
nice. How very
unusual. Oh, all together. Oh. What's his name?
Peter Marshall.
Tony. Okay, Carol. Are you ready to have a go at this?
Yes.
It's your first time up, but you know how it goes, and we'll begin. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best result, the best response to this.
Response, Dad.
Says Gene Blank. Okay, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. If you match the next one, you get $250. And if you match the bottom one, you get $100. Whom do you call on for a little help here?
Richard.
Richard?
I was going to say Harlow, but Gene I'll Harlow. Say Rayburn.
You'll say Rayburn.
Oh, hey.
Brett?
What about that person who's tops and taps, Gene Kelly?
Gene Kelly? Okay.
Charles?
Charles, have you got one?
I'd like Gina Lola Brigida, but I can't do that.
No.
And not get such a huge laugh from the audience.
Yeah, of course.
All right?
Charles is thinking, as you can plainly see, but he needs...
No, I know, but oh, his, I'm just checking adding. His answers.
For his brain
no.
to work.
No. Gene Autry!
Gene Autry. Okay. Gene Autry, Gene Kelly, and Gene Rayburn. Now, you may choose one of those, or you may come up with another one if you value your life. No, it's your choice entirely. You can make your own free decision here. Whatever you say is okay with us. What do you say?
I choose you.
Oh, I thought you'd never ask. All right. Now, let's begin down at the bottom as usual and see if Gene Rayburn is hiding, that rascal, if he's hiding under the $100 response. Gene Kelly, whose answer
What's
was
the
that?
That was your friend.
That was Brett's answer. Yes, indeed it was. No, I wouldn't expect Gene Rayburn to be hiding under the $100 number.
Hopefully.
I wouldn't even expect him to be hiding under the $250 number. Would I? No, I wouldn't. That's the one that Charles gave
you. Won't it be embarrassing if you're not up here?
Gene Harlow.
Gene Schwartz.
Earl, are you in there? If this doesn't come out, Gene Rayburn, don't you come out either. You're not only going to stay in there, but you're going to go to the back of the box there, okay? All right. You're in the corner now. All right. I'm not going to look, Earl. All right, Earl, slide it! Congratulations, my dear. Eat your heart out, Gene Kelly. Okay, now you got the 500. That means you have a total of 600.
Don't take the same pole at a dance school.
Okay, you're going to play now for 10 times $500 or $5,000. But remember to collect that. You have to have an exact match with one celebrity. Which one will it be?
Richard, please.
Okay, Richard. You're up, and you're going to face me, and here it is. It's worth $5,000. Blank Motors, M-O-T-O-R-S. Now, he's finished. Carol, we need your response. One you think will match his. Blank Motors.
General Motors.
General Motors. You're not trying to put American Motors out of business, are you?
No.
No, okay. All right, she says General Motors will match you for $5,000. Richard, what do you say to that?
I didn't know we could advertise. And...
Oh, you can't advertise.
All right, General Motors.
Oh! Okay. Attagirl! So you got $5,600. I see your husband's very happy about that. They're out of there. Okay, isn't that grand? The fella in the blue shirt down there is her husband, and who's that with him there?
Right beside him is my son.
Your son is to the right of your husband, right?
Right. Yeah. My neighbor, my brother, my mother, my father.
You got a regular clack here. Okay, well, you're all very happy for her, and we are too. And now let's press on and meet her next challenger and welcome David Olson. I guess Carol and David know each other, and she's very happy, and while she's catching her breath, David, we'll find out about you, please.
I'm a senior of in business administration, senior at Cal State Northridge in the San Fernando Valley.
Yeah.
And I just celebrated my first wedding anniversary.
Well, congratulations to you. What day was that? Recently?
17th.
Yeah. Okay. Is your wife here?
Sure is.
Okay. All right. We're very happy to have her here with us, too. And we'll come back to both of you in a moment or so. But right now, we have to depart from the usual and do this message. Go! Go. All right. Are you both ready? Here we go. Round one coming up. Push the button.
Oh,
as you can see, the machine is a little temperamental. David Olson, make your selection.
B.
Here we go. Harry's girlfriend has been spending so much time with her plants that Harry got crazy jealous.
How crazy jealous did he get?
And how much time has she been spending with her plants?
That's enough of that. Last night,
yes,
he burst into her apartment and blanked her begonia.
He was so jealous.
He was so jealous because she was spending so much time with her plants.
He burst into the apartment and blanked her begonia. Good for him.
That's it. She's pretending to read it. She can't see without her glasses. There she is now.
I'm allergic to begonia.
Oh, yeah.
What is a begonia?
This is not
a begonia.
You remember ruby begonia?
Yes, you remember. A begonia has a tuberous stem and a very fragile, irregular flower. And it's very beautiful, and the colors are varied. Some of them are very, very attractive.
I went out with one of those last night, I think.
Yes, sir. A tuberous stem,
Very irregular, and the colors were varied. She had sort of red head here and black there. It was disgusting.
All right, now Patty's ready, and we'll
she
call on David
half the time.
Harry's girlfriend has been spending so much time with her plants that Harry got crazy jealous. Last night, he burst into her apartment and blanked her begonia.
Bit.
He bit her begonia. He bit her begonia, folks. How does that grab you, Bill?
What show am I doing?
This is match game.
I'm doing very badly. I put, he watered on it.
Throw in the slop, sweetheart.
Yeah. Well, that'll kill
him. Or...
That'll show him. Bert, what are you saying?
Darling, I thought he just rushed in there with his big old ugly fat knife and stabbed it.
Stabbed the begonia.
Is that stab?
Poor flower. Charles.
The only thing you do to a begonia.
What?
You bed it. Bed it.
He bedded the begonia.
That's like a stomach.
Don't go on with it, honey. You just died.
Give him a chance to explain. What is it? What is bedding a begonia now? I know a little bit about flowers.
Well, it's a love triangle of passion, and anything can happen.
Okay, anything.
Right. Like in my neighborhood on in Hartford Street years ago, there was this man. And a nurse and a librarian.
Take three. Come on, three. We're rolling for
and
three.
And the librarian found a nurse. And, well, the doctor,
come on,
she must
camera
have read.
Three. There you go. Camera three. Oh, there you go. Well, I'm tired of rolling.
But it wasn't until the minister arrived.
Joyce.
Charles, later in my office.
Okay, honey.
I can't end this madness. I'm with Bill. He drowned the begonia.
He drowned the begonia. Okay, the little lady, the man says, Harry's girlfriend has been spending so much time with her plants that Harry got crazy jealous. Last night he burst into her apartment and bit her begonia.
Yeah, well, it's a very painful occurrence.
Yes, it was.
And I was embarrassed with my answer until I heard the word bedded.
Yes.
And I knew I was home free with eight.
He ate the begonia! That's close to bit.
Close.
No match there?
Oh, really? I'm in the gag. Sure.
Oh, yes!
Judges are very fair.
Right.
I've forgotten David's answer.
The fact is, you could not eat the begonia without
giving it a bite.
Because you cannot swallow a begonia whole. I have tried.
You can if it's bedded.
No, it's wrong! What do you say, Patty baby?
Hello. This is a little-known social disease among your begonia verbena.
A little-known social disease?
This is correct.
Among begonias.
Oh, yes. Pardon me.
He walked into that apartment and he infested it.
Oh, infested the begonia. Oh,
that's right.
And that's why the begonia got sick. All right. Where are we here? We're in the middle of round one. And that's one for you. And your question will come along after this message. Are you ready? Well, we're not. Yes, we are. Listen, we got to stop right here, but you will come back next time, won't you? Say yes.
Yes, yes, yes. Yes.
Yes. Oh, they're a dandy bunch there. And you're a dandy bunch, too. And I want to thank all of you for being here. Some of you will come back, and some of you won't come back.
Now, Charles has more to tell you about bedding and all that.
I don't want
to
hear anymore. I've heard more.
When the nurse found the librarian's hairpin.
Who is coming back? Quickly.
I'll tell you who's coming back. These are the ones who'll come back.
Bob Barker. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly, Arlene Francis, Richard Dawson, and Fanny Flagg.
Gene Mayron here for Match Game 75. Join us next time. Thank you. Goodbye.
Tune for Tattletales next over most of these CBS stations.